gonna try this headphone thing. Alright, checking connection. You are now live. How about here? Okay. So, here we go. So, here it is, Instagram. Thank you for cooperating for now. And then we'll see if you don't cooperate going forward. Facebook, we don't generally have a problem with. Robin's phone is generally tip-top. In a tip-top shape. So for my Instagram friends, if that feed comes out, you guys, then just plop over to Facebook. That's all I can tell you, because I don't know what to do. I don't know what else to do. Did I turn your volume? Oh, you're ringing? Oh, I don't know. Let me see. I think I did. I did not. Here we go. Now it's off. Okay, there we go. Oh, what a nice stretch. All right.
Okay. Oh, all right. Well, I have a little bit of shape. You don't? Even though it'll be gone. You could pull it forward a little bit.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I don't mind it too much.
Yeah.
A little bit.
I mean, arriving at your space. Huh? Noticing where you find yourself, noticing what are you bringing in, what are you leaving behind, or where, finding out where you find yourself. Belly in and up, chest rises, shoulders soft, chin tucked in slightly, sitting nice and tall. And if you would really take this as an opportunity to check in, do a little self-care, a little self-maintenance, a little self-reflection, maybe even self-care, I think it's really the best way to put it. As if it's, the way that I like to think about it sometimes is as if you're brushing your teeth, right? The emotional brushing teeth. Basic emotional hygiene. Checking in with the mental fortitude that you have and not feeling that if it's just not up to where you want it to be. It's kind of where I find myself today. It's just, I'm just a little mentally tired and I'm just not ready to deal with big things, and that's okay. Not every day you have that fortitude. You are allowed to say no, you're allowed to, you know, do a little self-check and take a moment for yourself and perhaps reschedule if you have something difficult or something that you perceive as a difficult or mentally challenging. Feel free to be like, hey, can we do this another day? I'm not quite up for it today. So if you're finding yourself anywhere there, allowing yourself the luxury, if you will, or the necessity, even. Sometimes it's not a luxury, sometimes it's a basic necessity to be where you are, right? To find the emotional state that you mouth, hold it at the top, tip in a little more, out of your mouth, let it go. Again, breath in through your nose, hold it at the top,
sip in a little more.
Out of your mouth, relax. Roll your shoulders up and back. Drop your head side to side. Maybe start swaying a little bit, either side to side or a big circles with your upper body. Run away, take it nice and slow, leaning in. Your second one, reversing the direction, unless you're going side to side, in which case just start going forward and backwards. Checking in with your breath. Finding a neutral, notice where the shoulders kind of drop themselves over the hips. And then notice if you're leaning a little too far forward, just kind of, you know, connect the sit bones and find the nice line, the shoulders over the hips. The right hand goes over your, left hand rather, over your right thigh. Right hand behind you, gentle pull into the twist of your right. Hold there for a moment. Maybe roll the head while you're under. Into your left side, and then again, maybe you're all in your head a little bit. We'll see how the headphone will work. We have still some tree cutting here going on, and I have finally been fully prepared to do what I need to do. Back to neutral. Coming over onto your hands and knees, and then again, inviting all breeze into a little bit of movement. Again, big circles, move forward and backwards onto your hands and knees. Exploring the space that your body is offering today. Notice if there's any extra space in the shoulder joint. Can kind of lengthen through the legs, right on the outside of your back, right underneath your armpits, hollowing out the armpits, hugging the shoulders in towards each other. And back to neutral, shoulders over the wrists, hips over the knees. The right leg extends back, find an extension through the heel, activate. Knee to nose, bring it in, round, push the mat away. Extending the right heel back, hip height, belly tight against the low back, again, knee to nose, bring it in. Extend your right foot long, hold it right there, cross your right foot to the outer left edge of your mat, tuck your toes under, look over your left shoulder, towards your right toes, and just a little bit of a stretch through the right side of the ribs. Back to neutral, extend your right leg, and then put it back down onto the ground, little shimmy, little shake. Left heel extends back long, keep the upper body structure in place, knee to nose, bring it in, round, push the mat away. Extend your left heel long, back into the nose. Last one, extend it long, hold it there, check in with the low back, with the belly, cross your left foot to the right side of your mat. Look over your right shoulder towards your right toes. Push into the left hips a little bit into the left rib cage. Notice if you can lift up through the shoulders, both of them. Extending the left leg back again. And then releasing onto the ground. Little shimmy, little shake. Whatever movement seems to find your neutral. And then tuck the toes, lift the hips back, down. leg lift. Lift your right leg up, open the hip, flex the foot, keep the right shoulder pressing down. Again, the structure of the upper body did not really change. You're still lengthening, lifting off of the shoulder joint. Maybe roll the ankle here. Just kind of play with any space that you are having. Extend your right leg long, close the hip, step your right foot all the way in, step your left foot all the way in. Halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, fold, release, soften, relax. One more time, halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold, right leg steps back, left leg steps back, find your way to plank. Forward elbows in, halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Left leg lifts, up and back long, bend your knee, flex your foot again, keeping the upper body square to the mat, especially the left shoulder still lifting through both of the shoulder joints. We're rolling your armpits in towards each other, maybe rolling the left ankle behind you, opening through the left side of the hip. All of the weight is in your right heel. Ideally, your right heel is down onto the ground, nice and grounded. Extending your left leg long, close the hip a little bit, step your left foot all the way in, step your right foot all the way in. Halfway lift, flat back, lengthen. Exhale, fold. One more time, inhale, halfway up. Exhale, left leg steps back, right leg steps back, you're in plank. Inhale here, forward elbows in, halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Again, shifting the weight into the legs, maybe stepping into the shape, one leg at a time, finding an extra extension through the shoulders. Notice where you are.
Just one, oh, there it goes. Oh my gosh, what the heck? All right, so hang in there. I'm gonna try one more time. Pause due to the poor connection. I don't understand what is happening. Poor connection. So, if I turn off the internet and then just rely on the 5G, can I do that? Hang in there, just pedaling out the feet. Okay, I'm gonna try this one more time. Checking connection, you are now live. Okay, I'm gonna try this one more time, you guys. I hate Instagram right now. Hate it. I hate it. Why does it keep doing it to me? It looks like I have a really bad phone signal as well. Yeah. Maybe that's why. I don't know. So weird. So again, if I guys lose you, then plop in back onto Facebook. Apparently Robbie's connection is way better than mine. I don't know what's going on here. I'm not really sure what to do with this connection at all. So we'll see if we get any more luck this time, but I doubt it.
But I don't know what she is. All right. High on the tippy toes. Bend your knees. Look where you're going. Step or float in front of your space. Halfway lift, flat back, lengthen. Exhale, release. All the way up, arms reach over your head. Bring your hands to heart center. Inhale, arms rise. Let's find the flow part. Exhale, fold. Halfway lift, flat back. Plant your hands, step back to plank. Inhale here, knees are not halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing dog. High on the tippy toes. Bend your knees. Look where you're going. Step or float. Halfway lift. Flat back. Are you lazy?
No.
Exhale, fold. You're rising.
Yep.
Arms reach up over your head. Hands to heart. Bring it in. One more time. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. That tells you what I was thinking about. Halfway lift, flat back. Plant your right arm down and back, just open, back to center, inhale, left arm down and back, back to center, stand up, look up, reach up, forward fold, easy release, halfway lift, flat back, plant your hands, step back to plank, inhale here, forward elbows in, halfway down, heart comes through, inhale, roll over your feet, downward facing dog, right leg lifts up and back long, knee to nose, round, shift your shoulders over the wrist, scoot it back, three-legged dog, right leg steps in, left heel goes down, warrior one, rise, stay for exhale, inhale here, arms go down, frame the foot, plank, three-legged knee. Halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet. Downward facing. Left leg lifts up and back low. Knee to nose, round. Push the mat away, resist. Three-legged dog, lengthen. Step your left foot all the way in. Right heel goes down, warrior one, rise. Stay for exhale, breath in, inhale. Arms go down, frame the foot. Plank, three-legged knees. Halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Inhale here. Out of your mouth, let it go. Tippy toes, inhale, lengthen. Bend your knees, look where you're going. Step or float, front of your space. Halfway lift, flat back, exhale, release. All the way up, arms reach. Heads too hard, bring it in. One more time, inhale, arms up. Oh, actually, sit down into chair pose. Right arm down and back. Back to center, inhale, left arm down and back. Back to center, stand up, look up, reach up. Forward fold is your release. Halfway lift, flat back. Plant your hands, step or float, chaturanga, mid plank. Heart comes through, inhale. Take your time, shoulders back and down, roll over your feet, downward facing. Right leg lifts, up and back, long knee to nose, round, shift the shoulders forward, high on the back heel, three-legged dog, lengthen. Right leg steps in, left heel dials down, warrior one, rise. Right back down, arms go down, frame the foot. Plank, three-legged knees, halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing dog. Left leg lifts, up and back long. Knee to nose, round. Three-legged dog, lengthen. Left leg steps in, right heel goes down. Warrior one, rise. Stay for exhale, inhale here. Oh, yeah, arms go down, frame the foot. Plank, three-legged knees, halfway down. Inhale, heart comes through. Roll over your feet, downward facing. Toes, inhale, bend your knees, look where you're going, step or float, halfway lift, flat back, exhale, release, all the way up, arms reach, hands too hard, bring it up, inhale here, settle in, out of your mat, let it go, notice the quality of your standing posture, notice if your knees are locked, if your butt is sticking out just a little bit, soften the knees a tiny bit, pull the tail under and down, active through the midsection, shoulders down, chest lifting, chin tucked in slightly. In your mind's eye, shift your weight into your right foot a little bit, the left knee comes up and into the chest, fire up your left heel, notice what's happening in the front left hip flexor here, and slowly start extending your left heel back, leaning into warrior three. Find your way, find your expression. Notice how the standing foot is supporting you. Draw your left hip down, fire up your left quad. Inhale here, Shiva squat. Hands go down, the knees go behind each other. Into a half moon off to your left, so right arm finds the floor. And then left leg lifts and opens. Stacking the hips, stacking the shoulders. Notice this way, you're opening through the hips. Notice if you're bending into your low back, pull the midsection in again at the space at the low back. Shiva squat again, wrap it all down one more time. Revolve half moon, left arm goes underneath your face, your left leg, right arm comfortable. Another breath in here, notice. Keeping the arms as they are, right knee bent. Step the left foot back, come up to twisted crescent. Pause here a little bit. And then right arm down, left arm up. Slowly open to warrior two. Try your left heel down. Inhale up and over, reverse your warrior. Into extended side angle, left arm reaches over your head. Finding a long diagonal engagement here. Stay here for a couple of breaths. Notice if your right hip is hugging under. Notice if your butt is sticking out. Notice how much of an engagement you have through your left quad. If you have a half bind or full bind, maybe the next time around. We'll see. Inhale back to reverse again, up and over, reach. Arms go down, frame the foot. Plant your hands, plank is next. Hold your plank right here. Shift your hips back, downward facing dog. Right leg lifts up and back long. Knee to nose, bring it in round. We're still on the right side. Scoot it back, three-legged dog. Right leg steps all the way in, warrior two again. Straighten your right leg. Come into a neutral through the hips, so notice what the hips are doing. Reach up with your right arm, revolve, triangle. Again, check in with the hips. Hips and thighs are scissoring in towards each other. Arms go to a T, only now you sass the left hip back. Reach, reach, reach. Trikonasana coming down. Breath in. And out. Again, stacking the hips and the shoulders. Look down for balance, right knee bends, up and over, reverse your warrior. Arms go down, standing splits, left leg lifts. Inhale here. Exhale, plant your hands, walk, step, float through your vinyasa. Nope, no Instagram. I know.
I don't know what I'm going to do with that. I have no idea.
High on the tippy toes, bend your knees, look where you're going, walk, step, float from the distance. Half a lift, flat back, exhale, release. Come all the way up to standing, arms reach, hands come to heart center. And then again, a little shift, a little grounding through the feet, gentle bend through the knees, tailbone under and down, ribs in, chest lifting, shoulders soft. Shift your weight into your left leg slightly. Bring your right knee into the chest. And then check in with the right front hip flexor. Notice what it's doing, right? How are you standing? How challenging the standing posture is. You really should be able to find an alignment that allows you to be here for a while. Fire up your right heel. Leading with the right heel, upper body leans forward as the right foot goes back, warrior three. Find your breath. Keep your right hip in. Left leg extending, right hip rolling down. Inhale here. Shiva squat, wrap it all down into the half moon to your right, left arm plants. Right arm lifts, right hip stacks over the left. Expand, find your place. Hold it for a moment. Back down, Shiva squat, square your body to the mat. Wrap it all in. Revolve half moon, right arm plants, right leg extends back, left arm comes up. Find your space, hold it for a moment. Left knee bends, step it back, slowly coming up to twisted crescent, pause. And then opening up to warrior two, towards your right, left leg is up. Up and over, reverse your warrior, stay in your left knee. And to extended side angle, left arm finds the cloth or the floor. Right arm reaches over your head, keep hugging the left hip under. Keep squeezing your right cloth. Looking for a long diagonal engagement. Great. Beautiful. Back to reverse. Stay deep in the front knee. Up and over. Reverse. Arms go down. Frame the foot. Left leg steps back to plank. Fire up your arms. Hold your plank. Hips go back. Down. your feet, downward facing dog.
Pedal out the feet for a moment. And then maybe drop down, take a sip of water if you have water. So annoying. All right, I am gonna give up completely and entirely, and you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna record it as a pure video. Okay. Facebook is going strong as usual. Thank you, Robbie's phone. Saving my ass on a daily basis. Directly over your left ankle, maybe a slight pressure.
click on here. Let's see what kind of fold are we gonna do today. Maybe just a simple fold. So I like to generally always start with more of an active fold. So if you keep the legs engaged, the feet flexed, I like to keep mine it's about a fist and a half, less than a hip width, but I don't like to keep them together for some reason. So just notice where you find yourself. Take the flesh out of the base, sits bones connected into the mat. Again, there's this hinge at the hips, right? So it's like you kind of like break yourself in the middle in a way. Arms reach up over your head. And then you keep hinging at the waist as you come forward, finding your shins, your ankles, or your toes if you have those available. And then bend your elbows, use your biceps to pull your upper body forward. The gaze is in neutral, facing forward as well. So you're not rounding quite yet, we will get there. Back of the legs are on fire. Belly pulling in, with every inhale you lift, with every exhale you pull, using your arms a little further in. So again, the active stretch is where we start. It's been a rough day. It's not even 1 o'clock yet. Yoga will help for sure. One more inhale here, exhale, completely release. Now into the passive stretch. So round the back, drop the head, release the shoulders, sink into whatever you can sink into. Soften the belly, release the legs. Again, it's not about how deep you go, but how willing you are to let go of your weight. Use your weight rather in a manner that's not resisting to gravity, but the opposite, given into gravity. Notice how much resistance your body is holding. You just keep checking in with yourself and then keep releasing, keep softening, keep leaning into that pool of gravity, right? Even if it's minimal, even if it's tiny gains of space between your upper body and your legs, it's totally fine. Slowly finish your exhale. Notice how that shape changed and evolved while you were in it. And very, very slowly and gently, you lift your upper body back up. If you want to use your arms to kind of support yourself, you certainly can. It's up to you. And you come into a simple seated position where you just pause and notice what happened, if anything. And if you have a bunch of pillows or a bolster ready, take the bolster and put it right behind you. Be nice with the completely sweating situation that we have going on over here.
that's totally fine. Both of the feet come in to the Baddha Konasana, otherwise known as the butterfly pose. And the back of your bolster is all the way in, you guys, at the low back. Or if you have pillows, you can use pillows. Or worst case, you can also use a block. Or worst case, you don't have to use anything. The bolster is really nice because we're going to lay on it. And then just notice if you need to adjust your low back a little bit. Maybe lift up the hips a little and settle back in. But letting the chest completely open, letting the back of your shoulders draw down in towards the earth. So big, big chest opening here. Collarbone, just try to let go of the fear of opening your heart or exposing your chest, right, in a very vulnerable manner. Notice if this pose lets you or holds any tension for you. Maybe you're kind of like, you know, trying to still protect your front with your shoulders slightly hunched forward. Maybe there is another places that you're kind of holding on to in a way. Just try to let go of any of that protection.
No.
number one, which is simply just laying sideways on the bolster. Maybe that's where you stay. The variation number two is you lift up and twist your chest a little bit further and then lay on the bolster with the gaze to your left, towards your legs. Maybe that is where you stay. Or the last variation is lifting up even more, twisting the gaze to away from your legs to your right, and then finding a deeper version of the twist. And sinking in, allowing the spine to do its work, again softening through the shoulders, the shoulders. Maybe let the elbows go a little wider so you allow for the chest to fully put its weight into the bolster. Releasing your way into the twist. hide you guys, so choose appropriately however high you want to be into the flat part of your sacrum, so just below the low back, just right above your butt cheeks, and then soften, completely release the hips, maybe a little adjustment for the shoulders, finding just the sweet spot for the shoulder blades, so they're not too close in, they're kind of more of a flat, but there may be a little bit of a space in between them, so just kind of notice what the position of the shoulder blades is good for you. And then just give it a go. Just relax here. Soften the feet. Release the legs. Feel the heaviness through the hips. Sinking into the block. The legs can always extend long if that feels good for you. Or they can stay exactly as they are. Again, depending on which one feels just better, honestly. And then if your legs are extended long, just kind of check in with the low back. So for me, it's a little too much for the low back because I have this particular tilt. Once I extend my legs, it just gets to a point where my low back is not entirely happy. So just notice if any of that is happening. Again, your body, everybody is a little different. Notice where you are. You can stay exactly as you are. You can also lift your legs up towards the sky. Just kind of notice if that gives you any satisfaction, whether the feet stay together or whether you open the legs wide. If you want to move yourselves against the wall and just move feet up the wall for Shavasana, you can also do that. Or obviously traditional Shavasana, flat on your back, flat like a, I don't know, like a drum, flat like what? Pancake? Yes, flat like a pancake. Plenty of options for your final rest. Take a moment, settle in into wherever it is that you wanna rest up. And again, a little mental scan of your body, releasing all of your body parts consciously into the mat. Hips heavy, shoulders soft. Maybe people have the jaw soft in the face. Hips heavy. me, this was probably one of the challenges, most challenging Thursday noon lunch break ever. Mentally. With all kinds of distractions, all kinds of technology problems, all kinds of external sounds coming into the space, my own thoughts interfering. So again, kind of noticing where you find yourself and whether, even though perhaps the practice itself turned out to be extremely challenging, perhaps it still brought some kind of a release, some kind of a recentering regardless of how difficult you may have been. Guys, oh so much. Have a great rest of the day, great rest of the work week. You know, keep up with the practice, do more yoga, do more sitting. Any questions, feedback, please do let me know, and then we will see you as usual on Saturday. Thank you guys so much.
And goodbye. And goodbye.